Hi, my name is Judy L. Moore, and I'm a freelance editor with Black Wolf Editorial Services. Over the course of a variety of different videos, I've been showing you how to use Scrivener to your full advantage. For those of you who've been watching the videos from the beginning, you'll know that I happen to have a Windows system. However, my writing partner, Anne Bell Feinstein, has a Mac system. So she's graciously volunteered to help me with these videos to show some of the differences and some of the features that are available on Mac only. So what have you got for us today, Anne?
All right. Well, I came across a couple of really cool features. And I'm going to, at some point, have to pull my headphones out. And you are going to hear a couple of clicks. It's just my headphones leaving my computer. But we're going to start with the dictation. Have you ever wanted just to talk to your computer and have it type for you?
That would be nice. It would help my hands. Yes.
Well, for people with arthritis, or if you happen to jam a finger, thumb, or wrist while you're trying to write and you still need to keep writing, it could be helpful. Now, keep in mind, dictation is not perfect.
Definitely not. So what do we do?
Now, there's two ways to access the dictation features. I can go to the edit and go all the way down here and hit start dictation. Now, if you look at the keyboard shortcut, it has FN, FN, which is the function button on my keyboard.
Okay.
So I don't usually bother to go all the way to the edit menu and find it. I happen to know the shortcut. So I usually just go function, function. And as you can see, a microphone popped up and the computer is typing what I'm saying. Period. Judy, comma, did I tell you Diana Kitty finally got off my lap? Period. Diana Kitty isn't the one with white paws. She's the cat who's mostly white. Period. And I turned it off.
Okay.
As you can see, it did an okay job. You're always going to have to with any dictation program. And I've tried several because I used to absolutely hate typing. Believe it or not, Judy, a writer who hated typing.
Now that's pretty unusual. Like, yep. Okay, so you've tried different dictation programs.
And this, the one built into the Mac is about the same and about as effective as some of the more expensive ones. And since it already comes with the computer, if I want to use it, I use it. But I've gotten to the point where I can type faster anyway. But it is occasionally helpful.
All right. So correct me if I'm wrong, but your punctuation, you have to actually tell it which to use?
As far as commas and periods, it will do contractions. Here, let's restart it. I don't want you to answer the door. Period. I won't be home for 3 hours. Period. As you can see, it will put in the apostrophes.
Which is a good thing.
Yes, I know. I'm always forgetting my apostrophes, Judy. I know. Now you're going to tell me to start dictating the manuscript.
Thanks.
No. I'll pass.
Okay, so if you're using the Mac version of Scrivener, you can do a dictation.
Yes, there's another feature. Now, here's where I told everybody I'm going to have to pull my headphones out. We're going to put my cursor back up here at the start of my text.
Okay.
And this will be important in just a second. What you just heard was me yanking my headphones out of my laptop.
Okay.
Now, we go into edit again. And there's this thing down here that says speech, right under my spelling and grammar. And I'm going to tell my computer to start speaking.
This is my novel. My cat is black with white paws. My cat has white paws, even though he is mostly black. This is revision 1, using revision mode. My cat loves to run and play. Philip.
I think that's enough, but you get the idea. My computer will actually read my manuscript to me, Judy.
That's cool!
Now, for those of you who are going, I hate that voice, How do I change the voice? Well, because it's built into the Mac, you won't find the option up here at all under any of the Scrivener things. You have to go to your System Preferences. See, I clicked on the Apple. You go to System Preferences. And as you know, it always takes a second to come up, but there it is. Now, all the options are under here, over down all the way down here in this row, at least on my Mac. They may be in slightly different places, but... And I go into Dictation and Speech. And see, there's the dictation options. And right now it is telling me it is using my internal microphone because I did pull my headset. And Text-to-Speech. I've got a number of voices. So let's see what Victoria sounds like.
Isn't it nice to have a computer that will talk to you?
Personally, I think that's a little hard to understand. What do you think, Judy?
It's almost like Siri, but not quite.
Yeah. Let's see what Alex sounds like.
Most people recognize me by my voice.
Okay. He's okay. And then Fred?
I sure like being inside this fancy computer.
See, that's too computerized. I keep going back to Bruce.
I sure like being inside this fancy computer.
So that's where I tend to leave it. But yes, and you can speed up and slow down.
Okay.
And you can set a thing so you can actually set a shortcut key for speaking the selected text, which I haven't done, because I don't accidentally want my computer to start talking to me and scare me or my husband. Which, funny story, remember Mr. Philip, Mr. Black with White Paws?
Oh.
He jumped. I had that shortcut thing enabled, and one day he jumped on the computer, and the computer started talking. It scared him, scared my husband, and I wasn't anywhere around.
Oh, I love cats. They're great. All right, so is there any other little things about this dictation or this read bag that you want to show us?
I think that covers the bulk of it. The only thing I will say, and I'll bring it up again real quick, when I hit the function button, the microphone pops up right in the middle of my text. Period. It's not too annoying for a short period of time, but if I was going to be doing this for a long time, I'd want to move it. Period.
It was in the middle.
Yes, it was. And it doesn't move. But you can always stop the dictation and restart it if it's bothering you. Obviously, you may not even be watching your screen while you're doing dictation. And Judy, I'm going to tell a little tale out of school, but I'm telling on myself. Very, very original draft of my manuscript, Path of Poison.
Yeah?
Part of it was dictated while I was driving in the car, because I hooked my computer to my Bluetooth system in my car and started the dictation because I had a 12-hour drive to make.
Hey, why not? You're still writing. Writer's gonna write anywhere.
And so I literally, my computer, it's not showing on my screen here, but I have a Bluetooth thing, which isn't enabled at the moment, but I'd enabled the Bluetooth on my computer, synced the Bluetooth to the Bluetooth system in my van, and started the dictation, and literally probably, quote, typed or dictated part of my manuscript during a 12-hour drive for approximately, I probably did about 3 or 4 hours worth of dictation during the drive.
What a way to get a first draft out. That's great.
Hey, they always say you have to adapt. I think that was a pretty creative adaptation.
That was. Okay. So thank you, Anne, for showing us some of the features that are only available on Mac. And hopefully those who are the Mac users found it very useful. And we'll see you next time.
Take care, Judy. Bye.
Thanks. Bye.